We get asked often, what's the difference between the wait and the wait until next millisecond multiple function? Let's take a look at this code. We have a couple things happening in this loop. We have the code that we're actually interested in executing, and then an iteration time which slows down the loop. We first might ask, are these executed serially? As in, this goes first, then this goes? And the answer is no. For instance, if I have 10 milliseconds in the loop iteration time, let's say that the code inside takes 2 milliseconds, then do we wait an additional 10 milliseconds for a 12 millisecond overall iteration? The answer is no. To understand this better, we can think of these happening in parallel, such that the time that the iteration loop takes should be 10 milliseconds in total, as long as the code takes less than that. To understand what we mean, let's take a closer look at the millisecond timer, which this wait function is based off of. If we look at our context help, we see that coming out of both the wait function and the wait until next millisecond multiple function is the millisecond timer value. What's that? Well, I'll right-click and create an indicator off of it, and give this some value as well, 10. We'll wire it in here as well. This and this will be equal, so we'll just look at this one. We'll run this a few times, seeing that the number just keeps going up. So underneath the hood, in my operating system, in my case Windows, there's a clock that's running continuously. And every time I run this, I return the value of that clock. This is the time by which Windows schedules all of its operations, and LabVIEW accesses that timer. So when we say wait 10 milliseconds, we're looking at the Windows system clock. We read whatever the value is, and then hopefully iterate the loop 10 milliseconds later. So that's what's happening here. We read the value of the clock, execute the code, and then wait the remainder of 10 milliseconds in order to iterate again. For instance, if the code takes 2 milliseconds to run, all of this here, then we wait an additional 8 milliseconds. If the code takes 6 milliseconds, we wait an additional 4 milliseconds. In that respect, both the wait and the wait until next millisecond multiple function are the same. So I could just go and replace this if I like. This will execute the same. Now, we obviously haven't gotten to the difference yet, so let's stay on the same pattern of showing you how they're the same. Because what happens now if the code here takes longer than what you specify? As we can see, I've specified this to take 10 milliseconds. But what if the code inside takes 15 milliseconds? What will happen? These timers will never truncate the code. They'll never stop the code from executing if they run over the time we've allotted. All that will happen is when the code finishes, there will be no extra wait before the loop iterates again. We'll see that we've taken 15 milliseconds to run this. We were programmed to wait for 10 milliseconds. We'll just iterate again. No wait. So the wait until next millisecond multiple and the wait function behave the same way in that regard. Okay, so what's the difference? The context help is always helpful. In context, I'll take the context help and read it. Waits until the value of the millisecond timer becomes a multiple of the specified millisecond multiple. Use this function to synchronize activities. You can call this function in a loop to control the loop execution rate. However, it is possible that the first loop period might be short. In other words, the wait until next millisecond multiple function wants to be on the millisecond multiple of whatever you wire in. In our case, 10. So it wants the value of that Windows system clock to end in 10. In other words, this clock. So what it does is the first time you run it, it tries to sync up with that clock. For instance, let's say that when you run this code, when the loop begins, let's say the Windows system clock is something like, so it will wait 8 milliseconds so that the next loop iteration will be 20, and then 30, and 40, and so on, as long as the code underneath takes less than that time. Of course, as we learned, if the code takes longer than the 10 milliseconds, then we're no longer even using this to time the loop. The code itself times the loop. If, on the other hand, we're using the wait function, it will just immediately start its 10 millisecond wait, so that the next loop, it should be 22 milliseconds at the end.